When a pilot lands at night, runway lights guide him in safely and reliably. Airport designers choose a particular kind of circuit for these lights, called a series circuit. That's what we'll be looking at in this segment of Physics in Motion. A circuit, as we've learned, is simply an electrical pathway that makes a loop. A series circuit is a closed loop in which the current follows one single path. The components are connected along the path, kind of like in this string of lights, and the same current flows through all of them. The wire from the plug joins one bulb to the next bulb, to the next bulb, to the next bulb, then back down the wire in one continuous loop. So the bulbs are in the same series. You know how when one goes out, all the rest of them do too? That's because if you interrupt a series circuit, it's toast. The path is broken and the current can't flow. Let's make our own series circuit using this battery type, some miniature bulbs, and some wire. I'll explain more about series circuits, which are the simplest of circuits, as we go. First, let's run a wire from this power supply, which is our voltage source. When the battery provides energy to make the current flow in the wire, we measure the current in units called amps, named after a famous physicist, André Marie Ampère. Now the bulb. The bulb has a filament with high resistance, making it hard for the current to flow through. The unit of resistance is named after another famous scientist. You remember his name, George Ohm. The symbol for ohms is the Greek letter capital omega. You'll see this symbol whenever we draw a resistor on a circuit diagram. Resistance creates friction, which makes the filament heat up and glow. And voila, light. In our one power supply, one bulb setup, we can see that the current has only one path to follow. That's what makes it a series circuit. No matter how many components we add, the current only flows on one path. This is a diagram of a closed circuit, meaning there are no breaks or switches, so the charge flows in a continuous loop. One more thing. The voltage drops as it's used up by the bulb. The more voltage is lost, the brighter the bulb shines. Now let's add another bulb in series. What changed? The number of bulbs. What didn't change? The battery and the wire, the voltage and the current's path. Voltage, current, resistance, the three interrelated properties of Ohm's law. We can use Ohm's law to show what happens mathematically when we add an identical bulb to our circuit. In this equation, the voltage across the single bulb circuit equals the voltage across the entire two bulb circuit, which equals the current through the two bulbs times the combined resistance of the two bulbs. We know that our overall circuit resistance doubled when we inserted a second bulb, shown in this equation. Resistance in the two-bulb circuit equals 2 times the resistance of the single-bulb circuit. This means the current in the circuit, which is constant throughout a series circuit, is half of what it used to be. As a formula, that is, the current in the two-bulb circuit is half the current in the circuit with only one bulb. What do you think that means for the brightness of the bulbs? The two bulbs are each dimmer than the single bulb we had before, partly because our electrical power is now split between them. So in a series circuit, current is constant throughout, and the voltage drop across each resistor decreases as we add resistors to a circuit with a constant energy supply. So let's add some resistors, a couple more bulbs. We still have the same number of batteries, right? So the voltage drop over the entire circuit doesn't change. But what did change? Our total resistance has doubled now that we have 4 bulbs. So let's go back to Ohm's law and see what it looks like when the current running through the entire circuit is halved. Resistance in the 4-bulb circuit equals 2 times the resistance of the 2-bulb circuit. Now think back to our original circuit, where we only had 1 bulb. Our equivalent resistance, which is the total effective resistance of the group of resistors, has quadrupled compared to the original circuit. We've solved for the total circuit resistance with a few bulbs, but what if we have a lot of them? Imagine we have an arbitrary but definite number of resistors. We call the first resistor R1, the second resistor R2, and so on, all the way until the last resistor, R n. The equivalent resistance of all these resistors in a row together is their sum, which is the resistance of the first resistor plus the resistance of the second resistor, plus the resistance of the third resistor, plus the resistance of the last resistor. This rule is one of the most important to remember about series circuits, how their resistors add together. What do you think happens when I switch open this circuit? Lights go out, right? I took a closed circuit, which is a circuit with no breaks, in which the current can flow continuously. When I open the switch, I make an open circuit, which is a circuit with a break. That means the current cannot flow. That's what happens with switches. Switch off, circuit is open. Switch on, circuit is closed, and lights go on. But in a series circuit, if any of the component breaks the circuit, say a bulb goes out, the current cannot flow, and the whole thing is no good. In this segment, we learn that a series circuit is a group of electrical components connected along a single path. We saw Ohm's law in action, and we now know that an open circuit means no current is flowing through, and a closed circuit means there is. That's it for this segment of Physics in Motion. We'll see you next time.
For more practice problems, lab activities, and note-taking guides, check out the Physics in Motion Toolkit.